my dearest wife. Letters from Olgierd to Iris, where I only as skilled with words as I am with my blade. Especially now, when an icy void grips my heart. I see how you look at me, and I see you with her. I cannot help you, but I believe I can cease harming you. This letter and this rose are my farewell. May you live in health, and remember but the good times, Olgierd.
You're not him.
Wait, I want to talk.
Not here. Not in this place. I'm sorry. I mistook you for another.
For Olgierd?
I thought he'd returned. To me.
What are you? A ghost? An illusion?
I am sadness.
Saw you before, but you weren't yourself. And I saw you again in your memories.
We've met. I don't recall. I had bad dreams. That is all I know.
I've come for the violet rose Olgierd gave you.
On the day we saw one another for the last time, I dried it and placed it in our chamber, at my bedside. I lay there for days, staring at it, until at last it crumbled into dust, as did I soon after.
So, the rose is gone?
Not from this world. Look. You buried my body and the flowers bloomed once more. And I was held in a deep, dark sleep. Only now have I awoken, just like my beautiful rose. When you placed the sketchbook on my grave, I remembered learning to draw my husband's face. Tell me, how is Olgierd? Healthy? Does he fare well?
Your husband's got a powerful enemy. Gontor O'Dim. Know the name?
I curse the day I first heard it.
Who is he, and how'd he step into your lives?
It's my fault. It was for me Olgierd summoned the Man of Glass. And it was my fault he wished for riches, then immortality for us both. Olgierd will best Odin, won't he? Now tell me, how is my husband?
Your husband hunts out ever stronger sensations. He tempts fate, because at heart he's unhappy.
At heart he is stone, so nothing has changed. And did Olgierd mention me? What did he say?
Not much, but I didn't ask about you. He just sent me to retrieve the rose.
The rose? The last I have left of him. His last gift.
Got a feeling the rose is important to you, more than a memento.
I remember so little. Yet when I think of my rose, I begin to recall what was. The world around me turns real. And my eyes open wide and I recognize things. Remember who I am and who I was.
A friend once told me about a case like this. Could be strong emotions that bind you to the rose, feelings we witchers call pins. They're what keeps you in this world.
Like an insect pinned in a collection case. Horrible.
Need to be honest. If I take the rose, you might cease to exist, as might the world you've built around you.
And what will happen then? Shall I be free of the suffering, the sadness? Is it the void that awaits?
I don't know.
I don't wish to suffer any longer. But I fear there will be cold and darkness until there is nothing at all.
I need the rose. Will you give it to me?
It's so fragile. Look, the petal edges have turned crimson, as they were on the day I received it. The one thing missing is the single drop of dew which slid down the leaf when I took the rose in hand. Or was it blood? Because I pricked my finger. I can't remember. You know, I never did read the letter from Olgierd. I didn't have to, and I needn't have kept the flower he left me. I've come to a decision. I shall give you the rose.
Our service thus ends. Thank you, stranger, for freeing us.
Before we go, some advice. Beware of the one called the Man of Glass. Stand in his way, and you'll meet a fate worse than death. seek salvation in glass that can't be broken.
Glass that can't be broken?
So long.
I'll remember you, Iris von Everek.
That no longer matters. Farewell.